What's up, guys? This is Sean, and welcome to another episode of the Yi Heng Podcast. And today will be a discussion about a video that I post on 7th April, which is regarding a question that how will property be affected by COVID. I'll just link it up there. And I made a statement where I think residential properties is going up. And you look into the comment sections, right? A lot of people are very negative towards things. And that has been the main concern during this period of MCO, right? Will the COVID hit property market? What's going to happen and things like that? And then I said property market will actually be better for residential side because interest rate has never been better. Developers are actually pulling off a lot of marketing and sales campaign and things like that, right? Then the supply is actually lower. Then all infrastructures, existing works will be continued and things like that. So I am very, very optimistic about the situation. However, it got bashed in the comment section. You guys can check it out, right? But I want to say now is I remember like last time I always tell my mom, right? Hi, mom. I think how I wish you can give birth to me earlier because like I would have leveraged on the previous property bull run, which is like 2008, 2009 time, right? How nice if I were to actually be like 3 years earlier, then I can invest even earlier so that I can really hop on the bull run. But I think now, as per what we noticed in the announcement of our Prime Minister, right, there's a few goodies that is happening in the property market. So the first announcement, right, will be home ownership campaign that is actually reintroduced. That's so cool. So it states like stamp duty exemption of transfer and loan agreement between 300,000 to 2.5 million. Right, subjected to at least 10% discount provided by the developer. The exemption on the instrument transfer is limited to the first 1 million of the home price, while full stamp duty exemption is given on loan agreement effective on the SPA signed between 1st June 2020 and until next year 31st May 2021. So it's a 1 year HOC period, but you don't have to pay stamp duty lah. So it's around 2%, 2.5% of the SPA price. So it's around 20 over 1,000, 30,000 for a 1 million property lah. Okay, that's a lot. Number two, RBGT exemption. If you actually sell your house between 1st June 2020 to 31st December 2021, so this exemption is limited to the disposal of 3 units of residential homes per individual, meaning you can sell 3 units like, if you have 3 units, lah, right? Then the last of all is the current 70% margin of financial limit applicable to third housing loan onwards of property valued at 600,000 and above will be uplifted during the period of the HOC, subject to internal risk management practices of financial institution. That means, right, during this HOC as well, last time we only talked about MOT, right, exemption of MOT and loan stamping fees and things like that. Now it comes with this game changer, right, which means if you are buying the third property right now, so now if you have two properties on your hand, which is both are residential, short house don't talk lah, right? So both two houses or two apartments, residential title, Soho also included. Your third property, before this, you can only be eligible for 70% loan. If you take a bank loan lah. So it means that let's say if the property is 1 million, maximum you can only take 700,000 loan. So the difference, right, you need to pay by cash. That's why a lot of people stop buying because of that. But now you are allowed to take a 90% loan provided if you are eligible for it, which means, right, if your property of these first two, right, the rental is actually higher than the installment, which is positive cash flow in the eye of the bank. The third one, you can take 90% loan again. And if the installment is actually lower than the rental income again, then you can go for this year. And also pulling back a clip where it's about Malaysia property market outlook, right, 2020. I've explained like how the government actually controls the market. They either want the property market to die or they want the property market to boom. It's all up to the government besides whatever supply and demand that we have. Okay, so at this current junction right now, what is happening, right? Interest rate is all time low. And what does it mean to us lah? So when interest rate is low, right, how does it impact me? Hello, right? So to investors, it doesn't make sense to put the money into FD anymore, right? So I think now it's like maybe 1.8% if you put into FD right now. And FD rates always affect the standard ROI that we all know. Like if you look at it, right, if you always hear like agents and property investors, they talk about, oh, per year, right, at least must have 6%, must have 5% of ROI per annum, only it makes sense. Where does this number come from? Like it doesn't just pluck from the sky, you know. So usually these are the numbers in reference to the FD rates. So let's say if FD gives you 4% a year, your standard of investment will require, let's say, 5-6%, which is higher than the FD rates. That only will justify the return, because if not, right, I put my money in the FD makes more sense. My means, like, I put there nothing, also 4% confirm. Why would I want to risk everything, right, for a maybe 6%? You get what I mean? So now if the FD rate is 1.8% today, a mere investment of 3% makes a lot of sense in the eye of the investor already. So when FD drops again, all this cash needs to go somewhere, because if not, right, inflation will just eat it up. That's why you can look into KLCI, our share market right now, right, is going insane. There's so much transaction. And I hear from my family members who are stock investors, lah. So it's so exciting right now in the stock market, because you understand, money cannot just sit still, it will lose its value. So what they will do, they will just take this money, is put either in stocks or in property. Then FD rates also affect our loan. A housing loan rate will be around 3.3-3.5, around that, right? And that will be the lowest in the decade. It's so close to PTPT end rate already, right? So the highest, just for reference, is 12% in Malaysia. I think in 1990 something, I was like 10 years old, I think. So as mentioned, FD rates is a tool that the government use, is either when they tune it up, when they want to kill the property market, they want to cool down the property market, but they will actually reduce it to actually stir up the property market. Number two will be cooling measures, where they announced previously was a very high RBGT rate, right? If you buy and sell within a year on your difference that you make, right, it will be imposed with a 15% RBGT. But now in this period of time, there's no RBGT, which means a lot of people will start selling. And whether you're lucky or not, this COVID really does affect a lot of small business owners or people who is related to the tourism field. So I'm sorry to hear that a lot of like pilots, a lot of my friends actually lose their job. When they actually sell their properties, right, then they won't be imposed in tax if they actually have a positive delta, which is the positive difference between the price, lah. But I think the most interesting one will be the third property. You are able to take 90% loan. And these are very structured in between the range of 600,000 and above. So for people who can afford like 600,000, which means you can now get 90% loan. These kind of excites me. If you guys know, I'm also buying a house, so it's seriously very interesting. But it also concerns me, where it widens the gap between the rich and the poor. If you look at it, right, investors, capitalists, right, this is like songs to the ears, you know, where you really, right, 600 and above, guess how many people will buy? And guess one person will buy how many units? Like for those cash rich or really businesses who have benefited from this COVID thing, they can get loan after loan after loan after loan at 90%, you know. Meanwhile, if you are still struggling to get your first and you were not prepared for this, unfortunately, that's bad news. What you can only do if you observe the property to be booming. So I guess this is a reaction by the government due to COVID. But when markets slump, right, so it's like a reaction. So when the government sees like, oh no, market is going to crash or whatsoever, they introduce the moratorium, they introduce lower interest rate now, they even put promotion, putting away cooling measures, right, and let the market grow. Also, you look into the supply section, right, developers are only clearing stocks, which is like whatever in the market right now, they will just clear stock lah. Right, with all the promotions and things like that, they will treat you like VIP if you are buying today. Hence, supply for the short term, right, I think will also be affected, because a lot of developer, my friends in developments, right, all get pay cuts and things like that. It means cash flow is not healthy. So I had this hypothesis because I got nothing to prove, but so I cannot bash in the comment sections. In accordance to our associates in the Makeover Guys, right? Because in the Makeover Guys, all we talk about is property only. And one of the earlier founder, Mr. Faizul Rizwan, also in his data and his talks, right? He also said that there's going to be a property boom, right? It's going to be a bull run, and he has been speculating this since March lah. How nice if I know this earlier lah, right? So I'm very, very excited to see what our Prime Minister just announced. I'm also very, very concerned because first-time homeowners, right? If you are prepared, right? If you are prepared all this while to own one, right? I think it's now time, right? It's really now time to take that step, right, to own a property, because it's low interest rates now. Supply is going to drop, which means rental market is going to go up, and it makes more sense in terms of ROI. So most of the investors will find other resorts to actually put in their money to make a return that is higher than the low FD rates. So property seriously now makes a lot of sense. Also, government is pushing for it. Government is introducing HOC again, right? Zero RPGT. And people who have money, serious money, are going to buy. And this will see, right, properties above 600,000 will boom. So as a conclusion, right, if your financial situation was greatly affected by COVID, I'm sorry, I would suggest you to actually play the survival card first. Make sure everything is fine, everything is proper for your family, right? Don't think about investment so hard yet. Get your footstep right, because I see the government is also trying their best to actually recover the market by putting in a lot of money to stir up job opportunities. So I really hope those people get a job first. And if we look into Malaysia's effort of the Kementerian Kesihatan, seriously, respect. I really hope the best for all of you, right? The karma will come if you have properties, and that will be. So clear all those first. Don't be too concerned about losing out or FOMO, right? Fear of missing out. Just make sure that everything is proper before you actually invest. As for my friends who are ready all this while, you have the savings, you have been planning to buy since, don't know, like 5 years ago. You're just putting a lot of excuses to it. It's now the time. Seriously, it's now the time. Take that leap. However, pick the right property lah. I guess a caveat to that statement means good property in bad or good times will be okay, right? Bad property in good or bad times will be not okay one, right? So just that now everything, they say when the water rises, all boat floats. Water rises, all boat floats. If your boat is very well maintained right now, it's going to float so high. So if you see got lubang one, you just like float a little bit lah. But those who is sinking already, water go up, you still sink down there. You sink even worse. Right? So I guess that's all. I just want to make that statement because I'm very excited lah. Seriously, I'm very excited. It's because I can see and witness a property bull run again. And I am very glad that I'm in a situation, right? Very grateful and things like that. So just want to document this moment, right? It's so exciting. And I can't wait to see this 10 years later, right? 10 years ago, punya Sean. Wow. So I'm very glad that if you guys are watching this, thank you very much for watching. And we're going to have a very, very good show in property market this few years. This few coming years. Wow. I can actually see the light. Okay. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. This is Sean Tan. And see you guys on the next one. Ciao.